It's good to welcome you again to St. Patrick's Cathedral for the next in the current series of recitals on the Willis organ by Mr. David Leigh, the organist and assistant master of the music. It is our hope that in these stressful times you will not only enjoy the music, but that should you be ill or perhaps self-isolating, it will bring you peace and enhance you in spirit. Mention the composer Edward Elgar, and we tend to think immediately of his Enigma variations, certainly Nimrod, or perhaps his Pomp and Circumstance marches, no doubt number one. What is not always recognized is that Elgar, regarded by many as probably the most significant composer Britain produced since Henry Purcell, also composed for the organ, although not at all prolifically, which is somewhat surprising, as, like his father before him, he was organist of St. George's Church in Worcester. Of his organ repertoire, Elgar's Organ Sonata in G, which is the subject of David's recital just now, is widely regarded as one of the most outstanding and successful compositions for the instrument in the late Romantic period. Elgar composed this work in 1895 at the request of Hugh Blair, organist of Worcester Cathedral, who wanted a new piece to play to a group of visiting American organists. The story has it that Elgar, who had received the invitation some 3 months previously, deferred much of the work on composing it to about a fortnight before the performance. In signing the completed manuscript, he is alleged to have added the words, "one week's work." Fortunately, when Elgar handed the organist the finished manuscript, there were only 5 days to go before the premiere, which proved to be insufficient time for him to prepare it properly. The first performance was described by one attendee as a terrible mess of poor Elgar's work. Although Elgar was magnanimous in refusing to blame the murderer, who he said had not had time thoroughly to study the victim. Elgar's Organ Sonata in G easily rivals the vast symphonic works of the Parisian organ school of Franck, Vidor and Viern, and in many ways can be considered typical of Elgar's orchestral music at the time. It shares the same melodic and harmonic colours, the huge dynamic range of the orchestra, and displays varied moods and contrasting themes. In it, the composer pushes the capabilities of the organ and allows the performer to demonstrate the scale and dexterity of the orchestra in one instrument. There are 4 movements. Allegro, with regal, majestic chords, very powerful, with a broad sweep showing Elgar's love of counterpoint and his seamless combination of themes. The second movement, Allegretto, the first part of the sonata to be written, in fact, completed, it said, in a day. It is a gentle movement with the melody in the left hand, eminently suitable for a cello. The third movement is Adagio, highly expressive, with a broad, expansive melody, which is thought to have its origins in cello music. Later in this movement, there are to be found forerunners of themes in Elgar's violin concerto and in his symphonies. The fourth movement, Finale, Presto, in which, after a quiet start, the energy and dynamics build as Elgar combines and reshapes themes from this and the preceding movement, and the piece draws to a flourishing conclusion. The Organ Sonata in G major by Sir Edward Elgar.
Thank you.
performance by David Leigh on the organ of St. Patrick's Cathedral, Dublin, of the Organ Sonata in G Major by Elgar, brings today's recital to a close. We offer Mr. Leigh our deepest thanks, as always, for his brilliant and virtuosic playing, in this case of a work which demands huge skill, not to mention a lot of physical and mental energy. So our grateful thanks to David. Thanks also to all who have listened in to this recording. I do hope that you will keep in touch and join us again for the next recital for a programme of music which will feature works by Jean de Messier, Henrich Andreessen, Jean Alain, César Franck, Jean Langlais, and Anton Heiler. Until then, please take care and keep safe and well.